FlyBase video tutorial, RNA-Seq series, part 1 using GBrowse. There are 4 ways to browse RNA-Seq data in FlyBase, and we will review them in this series of instructional videos. RNA-Seq refers to next-generation sequencing of the entire transcriptome for a defined developmental time, a defined tissue, or a specific cell line. It allows detection and comparison of expression levels of all genes active in the defined sample. We will look at an example of RNA-Seq data using GBrowse. Navigate to a GBrowse view by going to the gene page of your favorite gene and clicking on the GBrowse icon in the top left section of the page. Once in GBrowse, among the evidence tiers that are open by default, you will see a colorful tier labeled Developmental Stages Unstranded RNA-Seq. Note that for the purpose of clarity, some default GBrowse tracks have been hidden. Mousing over the display brings up a table of the developmental stages included in this particular analysis, arrayed top to bottom with a color key. In order to keep the window in view, you have to move the cursor so it is within the window. Note that each sample is offset slightly from the prior sample to allow a more compact view of the data. As shown later, this display option can be modified. Additional RNA-Seq analysis can be viewed by clicking on the Select Tracks option at the top or bottom of the GBrowse page. Scrolling down brings you to a section entitled Expression Levels. There are data for different cell lines, for different treatment regimens, and for different tissue isolates. For now, we will select 2 tracks and return to the GBrowse page. Return to GBrowse by clicking Back to Browser at the top or bottom of the page. You can see at the top of the page the 2 additional RNA-Seq datasets that were just selected. Since these are stranded data, unlike the developmental stages previously shown, the RNA-Seq is now divided into the plus strand and the minus strand for each dataset. You can reposition the tier by grabbing the label and dragging up or down. Another useful feature is formatting options for the RNA-Seq tiers. Clicking on the icon Configure this track brings up a box with several options. First, you can limit the view to a subset of samples by selecting adjacent samples. You can choose to increase or decrease the vertical space between the samples. You can choose vertical rather than the default tilted view to remove the sample offset. Finally, you can change the scaling method from log2 to linear. log2 has been chosen as the default since it allows the best representation of a wide range of expression from very low to very high. A linear scale often provides a better comparison of changes in expression from one gene across different samples. If you click on Apply Changes, you can see the modifications that were made on the developmental stages tier. This tier now just shows the 5 selected tracks, which are vertical with no offset and a linear scale. You may want to query the RNA-Seq data, for example, to find genes with similar expression patterns or to obtain a quantitative output for your gene of interest. Options for this type of queries will be presented in subsequent tutorials.